Hi folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Might and Magic, the World of Xeen. As per usual, we are just going to jump right on in here. Where we last left off, we had finished clearing out the Caverns of Illusion, and I believe that was about it. Well, no, I did some training and we had some money and stuff that I posited, so we should be pretty well broke, yeah. However, we have things and stuff to do now. We are actually going to go ahead and probably, I think, take a shot at saving Korak. So the first thing we're going to do is Day of Sorcery and Day of Protection. Ah, of course we don't have enough spell points and it's wasting my mana. So I think Day of Protection might actually give us, yeah, water walking. Okay, so we should be able to get in here.
Without the proper or not. Key to this tower, you may not pass, mortals.
Well, in that case, see, this isn't the Tower of High Sorcery. This might be Darzog's Tower? I'm thinking, the Tower of High Sorcery might be down near Winterkill, maybe. Because there is the tower out there. Let's find out. Town Portal, Winterkill. Okay, let me think, where was that? I think it was down... Oh, hey, random snow beast. Get out of my face. You too. Nobody likes you. You have funky hair. Okay, we do not have the... Unless this is the Tomb of a Thousand Terrors.
Only with the proper skill can I let you go in. Go
away. Well, that's like belching at me and stuff. Let's see here. I'm just looking for the dang tower with the rain buckets outside game. Why are you making it hard on me? Could have sworn it was... I'm sure that it's like out this way. I don't know what the deal is. Wait a minute. What is this? You found the Holy Book of Elvenkind. Alright. Somebody wanted that, I think. Oh, there's the tower too, that's Annie. I think it was this guy.
You have recovered the Holy Book of Elvenkind. The entire Elf Kingdom thanks you. Please accept this gold as a reward.
Sure. 60,000 experience points, alright. And 25,000 gold. Alright, so that's not too terrible. Alright, here's the tower. Is this it?
I see.
Yes.
The key to this tower. You may pass, mortals.
Okay, so we've got killer feats. Better watch out. Oh god, they're coming for me. Oh. Rove is the only one awake. Well, I suppose we should probably change that. Terrifying. Alright, now as I mentioned, we are pretty powerful at this point, so that's why we're just going to probably lay waste to pretty much everything in here. I'm really not too worried. Let's see, I just saved. I want to save again so I don't have to damn it. I don't want to rebuff. Okay, let's see, if I recall correctly, yeah, there's traps all over the place in here, and those dispel magic. Electric brew. I think this is electric resistance, but it deals damage to you. Yeah. I'm going to be giving all of those to Swell, I think. The box is empty. Cold resistance. The floors make farting noises at me. Alright. Anything in there? Some gold and some gems. Okay, we got stairs up. I'm sure this is going to be a trap, so I'm going to go ahead and just sleep. No! Alright. Fire, and is that it? Yes, okay. So time to go up. Go ahead, and I'm just gonna have her actually cast Heroism. I think that's probably all we're gonna need to lay waste to everything in here. I'm gonna go ahead and save again, just in case we start bumping into stuff that casts magic. But I think Heroism should be it. Well, okay, so they're going to throw all kinds of death magic. I am going to just reload, I think, because I'm terrible. I know normally I kind of stick with my decisions, but in this case, no. Alright, so this is dispelling, so I guess we can go through there. Some more Pandorian boxes. This flying fee just beating the crap out of Rove. Firebrew. And the reason that I'm giving all of this a swell is because in the later parts of the game, he's going to be the one that is saving my party's asses. Everybody else will be getting killed, and he'll be the one casting, like, Divine Intervention and rezzing everyone, fully healing them, and leading us to victory. So trust me, I have plans here. Alright, so we've got a mage of some sort. I'm trying to think how I want to do this. Not enough spell points. Oh, the squares drain our spell points. Okay. Damn it. I was hoping to avoid Rove's demise, but I suppose he does have to live up to his namesake, I suppose. There you go, Rove. Enjoy that endurance of 10 as his hit point total climbs ever lower. Oh, just wait until later in the game when we're fighting things that are dealing, like, thousands of points of damage and attack. Rove is going to be so sad. Go ahead and chunk. Have her cast heroism. Have him cast nothing. Can just melee these guys down. Oh, damn it. Alright, so that's the hallway of sadness and fail, so we're not gonna walk along that way. Go up the stairs, sleep. Alright, what do we got? Poison brew. Poison resistance. So what are his resistances looking at? See, that's not bad. And I believe that's like a flat reduction, so if something hits him for, say, 30 points of damage from one of those that he has 27 in, he will only be taking 3 points of damage. Hey, a scroll. A scroll of what? A scroll of implosion. Nice. That's something that's actually... No, I don't want to open the door. That's actually something that's useful to have in scroll form. Because it has a flat effect. And it's actually a useful flat effect. Because I think it's single target, though. So let's find out. It probably just failed. Wow. Okay, so note to self. Wow, Brunhilde, you just saved my party's ass. Yeah, Sheltum, shut up. I'm surprised that they actually dropped Swell before they dropped her. Well, she does have 60 hit points on him, I suppose. Alright, let's raise the scrub. Sleep. Alright, and if we're going to be fighting spellcasters, I am going to start throwing Day of Protection. Because them guys is mean. Oh, we got another one. Yeah, that's much more survivable. Okay. Oh! Oh, no! That's bad! Okay, that's something that is a little bit beyond us right there, I think. That is a fire dragon. Okay, so now we know, and knowing is half the battle. Wow. Okay, so we are avoiding... Oh my god, seriously? No. I feel like such a fucking chub reloading after these little crappy traps, but Rove's endurance just can't take it. God damn it. Have Devon open the door and fail miserably. Okay. Let's try... I'm just gonna use Cure Wounds on him, because it should be like two castings and he's full health. Yeah, see? Because he's only got 20 hit points. Okay, so what we got here? More feed. Alright. Random goodies. Magic Brew. Ah, damn it, I accidentally gave that to Chunk. Whatever. Energy Brew. Uh-oh. Damn it. You know what? Whatever. That was my own fault. How are we looking on gems? We have 258. Apparently these sorcerers are definitely worth it. This is just No. Alright, we're gonna rest. Go ahead and Day of Protection. Now, it would be a fight that we might be able to do if Rove weren't immediately dropped because he has Dragon Sleep. But even still, little much. These freaking anti-magic squares. What we got here? Just a scroll, alright. Oh, I think I remember this. I want to sleep. Alright, maybe this wasn't... I could have sworn there were, like, power liches or something up here. Chunk is finding all of these scrolls, and I'm sure they're all, like, Starburst and Implosion. Jesus, Wand of Daily Sorcery. I don't even know what that is. But I'm gonna hold on to it. Oh, that's Wand of Daily Sorcery. I'm an idiot. That's Wand of Day of Sorcery. Well, we are rolling in gems for the time being, so I suppose we can kind of afford to be a little bit crazier. Mysteries of Light. Eh? You're unable to learn this spell. Learn the spell Prismatic Light. The Art of Magic. Prestidigitation. I think we want everybody to learn this. I want to say, like, gives you bonus spell points or something. I think that is what it does. I don't know. I know it does make you a prestidigitator. Wherever that is. Yeah. I think it gives you bonus spell points. Freaking sorcerers. Just that one. Nope, just some feats. Okay, what do we got here? Skeleton key to Darzog's tower. Okay. So now we can get into Darzog's tower. Okay, can I? I did not want to do that. I want to save because I'm a coward. Day of sorcery, day of protection. Up we go. Darzog's tower is the one in the center, and that's where Korak is being held. Screw you, wizard. Sorcerer, whatever you're supposed to be. Oh god, feet. Who will take the gems? Chunk! 20 gems. Oh my god. So much rage. And, like, part of it's my fault because I'm not exactly, you know, I'm, like, kind of just rushing through this. But still butthurt. Alright, I think you bang this. And now when we go down, there will be gems in the gem barrels. Res his stupid butt. Day of protection, day of sorcery, because otherwise I'm going to fall through the clouds to my death. And now we cast jump. Thanks, game! Of course, it just had to be the time. Aw, barrels are out. Oh, there we go. See? And there were some cloud golems up there as well. I think, though... Let's see here. I think that was all that we really needed to do up there. And what is his? His endurance is 8. That is just like... Oh. Poor bastard. Freaking ogres. I'm not even gonna waste time with you guys. Seriously, game. Let me move. Thank you. Enter River City. Let's go res the freaking mage, who's probably got like 12 hit points to his name now.
May we help you?
Let's see, what are you looking at, Rove? Look at that, 12 hit points, one for every level. Well, that's just wonderful. I'm trying to think of places that we can go to raise his endurance. We could go back to the Castle of Illusion, or the Castle of Illusion, the Cave of Illusion, but, like, I don't think we're going to be able to raise it in any great manner there, so I suppose.
I see you have the key to this tower. You may pass, mortals.
We might as well try this. This could be bad, because Darzog, I think he eradicates people. Come on. Oh, for Christ's sake. Carnage hand, huh? Not too dangerous. We're gonna sleep, though. Because it looks like we have anti-magic squares here. Just going through all of the food. Okay, so we got a pack of Carnage hands. Throw all of our buffs. And maim. Floor grate. With some gold and random assorted goods. Nothing here. Alright, Rove. Jump. Come on, guys. Things are slow, though, which is kind of nice. Hey, some more gold and assorted junk. And stairs up. Okay. So we are going to go ahead and, in this case, teleport. No, I want to teleport for 2 squares. Because these anti-magic squares are seriously rustling my jimmies. Seriously, not a thing to be had. Alright. Okay, so go ahead and cast for 2 squares, and I'm gonna save, and up we go. Alright, that is, I think, one of his, like, trainees. That is not Darzog. That's what Darzog looks like, but that is not him. See, and I can't tell if that square is, like, immediately in front of us. Yes. Oh, and it also teleports us out of the place. That's great. Alright. Oh, day of protection, day of sorcery, and jump. Alright, what do we got here? Book of Speed, Chunk, have at it. Anybody? No, just Chunk. Oh, and it passed time, too. Alright, great. I'm really not too worried about these guys. The only thing in here that really worries me is the Darzog apprentices or whatever they are, illusions. Oh, hey, look, Rove died again. What a twist. Ugh. Need to go find that damn fountain that's like plus 100 hit points. Give him some survivability. What am I looking for? Cure wounds. I need him to cast jump. Here, let's see if maybe we can find like a tome of endurance or something. Tome. Book of Accuracy. I want that on. I'm gonna give that to Swell, actually. Plus 20 accuracy. Personality. Well, that's kind of obvious. That's Gold Leaf. Endurance. Hey, Rove. Bam. So now he's probably gonna have like some of the most hit points in the party. Look at that. 108. He went from 12 to 108. So now Rove can actually probably survive a couple good swings from probably pretty much anything at this point in the game. Might have another go at that fire dragon. Although I don't think we'd be able to kill it in one round, so probably not be worth it. Book of Might. I'm gonna give that to Swell, kind of shore his up a little bit. Let me see here, where can I go? Spell failed? What? Why are you failing me on my jump spell game? Well, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, I might be able to. I'm gonna save before I do this, because I'm either gonna get exactly where I need to be or I'm gonna rock my party. And I would really rather not do that. And I'm where I wanted to be. Intellect, here you go, Rove. Have even more spell points. Look at that, 204. That is not an insubstantial number of spell points. Alright, so we cleared this. That actually wasn't too bad at all. And now Rove is no longer quite the squishy fail boat. I'm sure some of you will be happy about that. I'm still largely annoyed with him because it's Rove. However, he does now have a substantial pool of spell points. I'm okay with that. Goldleaf's actually getting better too. She's at, you know, 170. I think these are actually clones, not apprentices. I don't know why I keep calling them clones, though. I'm trying to remember whether or not it's... wise to open these doors. Yeah, they are clones. So how are we looking? Yeah, look at that. He's still got 80 hit points left. I'm mystified. This might be the real one, though. Or maybe not. I don't remember where the real one is. I know he's in this room. There he is. Petrifying half my party. That's the real one. Alright. Well, Chunk's still up. Oh, Chunk, why? Alright. Let's see, was I smart? I did in fact grab Town Portal. This is what Swell is for.
Can I help you?
Go ahead and... Yeah, Darzog, as you can see, does not screw around. Immediately petrified half my party, killed most of the rest of them. Chunk decided he wanted to barbecue himself on a chest, so yeah.
I see you have the key to this tower. You may pass, mortals.
Yes, yes we may. Okay, and now we're gonna do this the quick way, which involves teleporting. Where is my jump spell? Oh my god. Come on, guys. Get with the picture. Let's see if I want to go like this. Like 1, 2, 3, 4. I think. Yep. Okay, go ahead and sleep again. I'm gonna go ahead and Day of Protection and Day of Sorcery. Save. Because Unrelenting Cowardice. Jesus Christ, Chunk! You're letting me down. Look at that. Negative 333 health. Whatever that was, it was not playing around, and Chunk paid the price. Go ahead and power cure. There. Anything in the bed? Chunk! Nothing. See, this is, yeah. Chunk presses all of the buttons, pulls all of the levers, and Rove drinks all the things. Alright, Chunk. Hey! 5,000 gold, 100 gems, and some miscellaneous goodies. Okay. This. Oh, is apparently Carnage Hands. Okay. This is what we were looking for right here. Because I believe this is Korak, yes.
Thank you for rescuing me from Darzog's clutches. I didn't know that someone else had received my message. Xeen's hideout is just above us in the clouds. You will need the sword the adventurers were working on in the dungeon of Newcastle to defeat Lord Xeen. You must make haste. Xeen plans to summon an army from the dark side to conquer our world.
All right. You only get this once. Well, no, I take that back. Well, I think you get this once. The 1 million experience points in text with exclamation points. You get this more than once in the game, but you only get like the holy choir and everything once. For being awesome and saving Korak, who then promptly teleports out. All right, we'll climb the ladder. And then this... will take us eventually to go fight Lord Xeen. However, here, we'll show you guys this really quick. I think, yeah, Xeen, 9 north. This is teleportation instructions. You have to teleport 9 squares to the north, and it will get you to Xeen's castle. However, we are not even remotely prepared for that. We have a bit of stuff yet that I want to do before we deign to tackle Lord Xeen, because he is kind of a hard ass. Okay, we can just teleport down. Don't really care. Okay, so we've saved Korak, and now we know that, you know, the Xeen Slayer sword is in the basement of Newcastle, which is the castle that we own and are repairing. However, we need mega credits. So, what we've got to do now is hit up the Dungeon of Terror, loot that. I've got to freaking find the stupid thing, and for whatever reason, I can't remember where it is. Let me think, what else do we have to do? We can go traipsing around in the desert. We have to find that chick's thing that the gargoyles stole, and a couple other things. Seriously, Ogre. But as you can see, there is not too much in the world at this point that really is a threat to us. Everybody's sad because we're in the desert. And let's see here. There's the war zone. Hello, random ogres. Oh no. Damn it. They have protection, and now we're going to just face roll everything. It is quite impressive just how much more powerful having buff spells running on your party makes you. It's quite crazy. Shoo, Jouster. Shoo, other Jouster. You too. So I think this is another one of the seasonal shrines. Yes. We're just gonna skip that because that is a quest that I don't think I have ever done in its entirety. Because it's such a huge pain in the butt. Alright. We're gonna just kind of follow this up around and see if there's anything. It does not look like it. Dang. Uh-oh. This is a problem. Uh-oh. Can I cast? No. Wait, what did that say? Oh, can't cast it while engaged. Oh, but... Yeah, saw that coming. So that's why gargoyles are so dangerous, because no matter how powerful you are, if they can hit you, you're done. Okay, so where was this? What didn't I do? Was this right before we... Yeah. Okay. That. Get all of this. I suppose one thing we should probably do is hit town and actually do some training. Get our levels under us. Okay, do that. Give us our million XP. Only get that once. And yes. I suppose we can actually just freaking town portal out. We'll go to River City, sleep. And we will do some training. And then I think I'm gonna call it an episode.
Looking to good job.
I love that you get a million experience points and it's like a level. Kinda ridiculous. Let's see, how are we looking? I am gonna deposit gold and stuff really quick. And then I'm gonna call it. So deposit, gold, 20,000, gems, 248. No, I left one. There we go. 1,000 gems, 350,000 gold. We were sitting pretty good. Accidentally deposited less gold than I initially intended to. 9, 2, 6. There we go. Okay. So now I'm going to call an episode. So, as per usual, thank you for watching. I will catch you all next time. We're in probably the Dungeon of Terror. Until then.